Hello students, today we are going to perform the first experiment, that is to determine the alkalinity of a given sample solution due to the presence of carbonate and bicarbonate ions with the help of NBET and HCl by using phenolphthalein and methyl orange indicator. First of all, we talk about object. We have to determine the alkalinity. What is the mean of alkalinity? The meaning of alkalinity is to determine the concentration of alkali. And the sample solution is alkali due to the presence of carbonate and bicarbonate ions. It means we have to determine the concentration of carbonate and bicarbonate ions separately. And as we know that the carbonate and bicarbonate ions are basic in nature, and that's why we need a standard solution which is react with them very well. And that is basically a NBET and HCl. Here we have to determine the concentration of two ions, carbonate and bicarbonate ions separately. That's why we need two indicators. First is phenolphthalein and second is methyl orange. That's why the object is to determine the complete object of the today's experiment is to determine the concentration of the alkalinity of the given sample solution due to the presence of carbonate and bicarbonate ions with the help of NBET and HCl as in a standard solution and by using phenolphthalein and methyl orange two indicators. Okay. And for the same, we have to go for the titration. Basically, when we have to determine the concentration, whenever we have to determine the concentration, we have to go for the titration. And for the titration, we require three chemicals. First is known solution, second is unknown solution, and third one is indicator. Unknown is given sample solution, known is or the standard solution is NBET and HCl, which reacts with the unknown solution in a very well manner. And third one is indicator. Here we have to determine the concentration of two ions. That's why we are using phenolphthalein and methyl orange two indicators. Okay. For the titration, we require some glassware. See, first we require a burette. That is be of 50 ml, which we use in our chemistry lab. And we have to fill the burette with the help of a funnel. And we always have to fill the burette with the standard solution. Now, this is a conical glass, and we have to take the 10 ml of unknown sample solution in conical glass. This is a pipette. This is a funnel with the help of which we have to fill the burette. This is two beaker, one of having a unknown solution and one of having a known solution. Okay, first of all, what we have to do, we have to fill the burette. Burette is V of 50 ml and it basically having a reading from 0 to 50 and it should be filled with the standard solution. So first of all, we filled it with the standard solution with the help of a funnel. We have to remove the funnel before. Start to titration, and we have to fill the liquid till the zero reading. The lower meniscus of the standard solution should be set at zero. The burette is completely filled with the standard solution. Now what we have to do, we have to take that 10 ml of unknown sample solution or the solution which have the carbonate and the bicarbonate ions in the conical flask. And that we take with the help of a pipette. We took 10 ml of sample solution in conical flask with the help of pipette. Now, what we have to do? We have to add indicators because the indicator will show the completion of the reaction because we know that it is a basic solution, it is an acid, both are colorless. Indicator will responsible for show the endpoint, and that they do by changing their own color. As we know that this unknown sample solution contains two ions, carbonate and bicarbonate ion. Carbonate ion is a strong base. On carbonate ion, the phenolphthalein indicator works. And phenolphthalein indicator, this is the phenolphthalein indicator. We have to add one or two drops of phenolphthalein indicator in a conical flask. See, a pink color will appear pink color will appear due to the presence of the carbonate ions. Carbonate ions react with the carbonate ion, which is a strong base, and phenolphthalein gives a pink color in a strong basic region. Now what we have to do, we have to start the titration. Titration is nothing, it is we have to slowly add the standard solution in a sample solution. See, the color change, the pink color disappear. Now what we have to do, we have to note out the reading in the observation table. The initial reading for the phenolphthalein indicator is 0 and the final reading for the same one is 2.8. okay, so now what we have to do, this solution still contain the bicarbonate ions, and for the neutralization of the bicarbonate ions, what we have to do, we have to add few drops of methyl orange indicators. As we add 2 drops of methyl orange indicator, the yellow color will appear. Now what we have to do, we have to again titrate it for the bicarbonate ions, and we took the reading in the observation table for the methyl orange indicator, and the initial for the methyl orange indicator is 2.8, which is the last point for the phenolphthalein because we continuously titrated it. Now we have to add, or drop by drop add, the standard solution in the unknown solution, and we have to stop our titration as the color change. See, now the yellow color will convert it into a wine red color or orangish color. It is the end point of the complete titration, and the reading for the final reading for the methyl orange indicator is 11. That we have to add these two readings in our observation table, and with the help of these two readings we have to calculate the strength of our unknown sample solution. Similarly, we will perform the note down the two more readings with the help of the same procedure. Okay, these are the reactions which are involved in this titration. And this carbonate and bicarbonate, both are ions which are present in a unknown sample solution, and they require acid to become completely neutralized. And carbonate requires acid and it becomes neutralized. Bicarbonate requires acid, becomes completely neutralized. And here we explain these two reactions with the help of the indicators during the titration. Carbonate requires a positive, will become a bicarbonate, and this reaction will take place in the presence of the phenolphthalein indicator. And during this reaction, the carbonate requires a X mL of N by 10 HCl. And as we know that we started the titration at a 0 ml of the burette reading, and the color of the phenolphthalein disappear at a X mL. For example, X mL, but we know that the reading is 2.8, and this will be takes place at a phenolphthalein indicator. In the same solution, we add methyl orange indicator in the conical class. Now we have a 2 bicarbonate ions which is already present, and one of the bicarbonate ion is which is formed by the carbonate ion. They both neutralize in the presence of the methyl orange. As we know that the complete titration requires Y mL, capital Y mL of N by 10 HCl. As we know that the carbonate requires a 2 volume of acid to become a completely neutralized. Here we express only 1 volume. So it means for the complete neutralization of the carbonate, we require a 2 volume of 2 times of X mL. Okay, and based on that, the acid required for the bicarbonate ion is Y minus 2 X mL. Okay, now we move to the observation table. This is the observation table based on our titration and based on our chemical reactions. This is the first of all, for the first reading, we took volume of sample solution taken. We took a 10 ml of unknown solution in a conical glass, and we filled the burette reading with the N by 10 HCl. In burette reading, we write the reading of the HCl. Phenolphthalein, first we add the phenolphthalein indicator in the conical flask. For the snorkeling, the initial is 0 and the final, where the pink color will get disappear, that is at 2.8. And in the same solution, we have the methyl orange indicator. And for the methyl orange indicator, the initial is 2.8 and the final is 11. And now, what we have to prepare about these two readings, we have to calculate the volume of N by 10 HCl required for the carbonate ion and for a bicarbonate ion separately. And as we know that for the carbonate, the volume required is 2 times. It means 2 multiplied by 2.8, that is 5.6 ml is required for the carbonate ion. Similarly, for the bicarbonate ion, that is here total total minus the volume which is required for the carbonate ion. That is being used for the bicarbonate ion. That is 11 minus 5.6 is equal to 5.4. Means 5.4 ml of N by 10 HCl be required for a bicarbonate ion. Okay, with the help of these two readings, now what we have to do, we have to calculate the strength of carbonate ion. Carbonate ion, first of all, we have to calculate the normality, and we calculate the normality with the help of the normality equation. Normality equation is nothing simple. Simple, N1 equal is equal to N2 V2. N1 V1 is to be used for an unknown sample solution, N2 V2 for a known solution. Unknown, as we know that, which is provided to us, that is, normality is not known, that is simple, N. Volume of unknown sample solution which we took in the conical class, that is, we have 10 ml. Known, for a known as we know that, that is, we have N by 10 HCl for a carbonate. N by 10 HCl means normality is 1 by 10. Known is HCl for a carbonate. That is, we have 2x or with a 5.6. So we put 2x. As we solve it, we get a normality. The value of the normality. Now, what we have to do? We have to calculate the strength of carbonate ion. The formula of the strength is normality multiplied by equivalent weight of carbonate ion. Normality, we get the value of the normality. Now, what we have to do? We have to multiply the equivalent weight of carbonate with the normality. Equivalent weight of carbonate is 30. As you multiply it with the normality, you will get the concentration of the strength of the carbonate ion, which is present in a given sample solution, that is 1.68 gram per liter. We calculate the equivalent weight separately. The formula of the equivalent weight is molecular mass upon N. Here N is 2 because in case of ion, the charge is 2. So we have to divide the molecular mass divided by 2, and that is 30 in this case. Now, similarly, we have to calculate the strength of bicarbonate ion. Similarly, first of all, we have to write the normality equation. N1V1 is equal to N2V2 dash dash dash. This is for unknown. Again, this is for unknown. Unknown, we know that the sample which is given to us, normality is not known. We took a 10 ml of unknown sample solution in a conical class. Known, that is 1 by 10 for HCl. And the reading of the HCl for a carbonate ion, for a bicarbonate ion, is y minus 2x. So that we put y minus 2x. And now, the normality is y minus 2x divided by 100. Now, what we have to do? We have to simply calculate the equivalent weight of the normality to find out the strength. Similarly, strength of bicarbonate, normality multiplied by the equivalent weight of bicarbonate ion. And the equivalent weight of the bicarbonate ion is 61. And in this case, the equivalent weight is 61 molecular mass divided by N. N is 1, as we have only a single negative charge on the bicarbonate ion. And based on that, we calculated, and the strength of the bicarbonate ion is 3.2 gram per liter. The total alkalinity, we have to just add them. Thank you.